Come on, put your hands together. If you want to rise up to your feet, you can stand up and worship the Lord wherever you are right now. Come on. Let's sing to the beautiful one.
Wonderful, so wonderful is your unfailing love. Cross is spoken mercy over me. No eye has seen, no ear has heard, no heart can fully know how glorious, how beautiful you are. A beautiful one I love, beautiful one I adore, beautiful one my soul must say. Come on, a beautiful one now. We love you, Lord.
Beautiful one.
We praise you, Jesus. Beautiful one my soul must say.
So powerful.
So powerful, so powerful.
Captured my heart with this love.
Cause nothing on earth is as beautiful as you.
If you sing to the Lord, come on.
You opened my eyes to the wonders in you. And captured my heart with this love.
Hello friends, it's great to be able to join with you and to share with you. And so, yeah, just thank you for the opportunity for me to connect with you here today. So before we begin, let's just have a word of prayer and commit our time to the Lord. Yeah, Father, we just thank you, Lord, for your great love for each one of us, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that through the death of our Messiah Jesus, Lord, we can know you in our lives, Lord. We thank you that we have your Spirit in our lives, Lord. We thank you that our sins are forgiven and that we are your sons and daughters. Father, we thank you for so many blessings in our lives. And Father, we pray now that you will unite our hearts together, Lord. We pray that our hearts will be open to hear from you as we spend this time now. In Jesus' name, amen. Wonderful. So today, friends, we'd just like to share a little bit from Psalm 119. And this is a wonderful psalm. So I'd like to start by reading from Psalm 119, verses 97 to 112. Oh, how I love your law. It is my meditation all the day. You, through your commandments, make me wiser than my enemies, for they are ever with me. I have more understanding than all my teachers, for your testimonies are my meditation. I understand more than the ancients because I keep your precepts. I have restrained my feet from every evil way that I may keep your word. I have not departed from your judgments, for you yourself have taught me. How sweet are your words to my taste, sweeter than honey to the mouth. Through your precepts I get understanding, therefore I hate every false way. Your word is a lamp for my feet, a light on my path. I have taken an oath and confirmed it, that I will follow your righteous laws. I have suffered much. Preserve my life, Lord, according to your word. Accept, Lord, the willing praise of my mouth and teach me your laws. Though I constantly take my life in my hands, I will not forget your law. The wicked have set a snare for me, but I have not strayed from your precepts. Your statutes are my heritage forever. They are the joy of my heart. My heart is set on keeping your decrees to the very end. Amen. So the word of God really keeps us alive and is our spiritual food. So we need to take the Bible seriously, you know, enthusiastically, and eat it and feed on it, or else we will starve and die. And Psalm 119 is like a song expressing love for the Word of God. It's full of praise and thanksgiving for God's statutes. Christianity has a lot of great values and beliefs, but these beliefs don't automatically produce changes in our character or in our lives. And beliefs have to be turned into character through practices and disciplines. And one of these practices is using scripture. So believing it and acting on the scriptures. And we need to do this each day, each day. And Psalm 119, as I said, is all about the love of God's word and the practical use of God's word in our lives, and the way it shapes us and forms us and forms our character. In verse 9, we read the question, how can a young person stay on the path of purity? And then it goes on to give us the answer, saying, by living according to your word. So if we want to use, if we want the scripture to transform our lives and our belief to be turned into character, we have to do three things. And here's the points. We have to recognize its majesty and authority. We have to tap into the Bible's power. And thirdly, we have to walk in its light. So firstly, let's look at recognizing its authority, the Bible's authority. In verses 89 and 90 of Psalm 119, we read these words. Your word, Lord, is eternal. It stands firm in the heavens. Your faithfulness continues through all generations. You established the earth, and it endures. The word law is mentioned a lot in the Bible, and in this psalm in particular. And maybe when we think about the word law, we think only of the Ten Commandments. We think only of a small part of the Bible. But actually, when the Bible refers to the term law, it means the whole of the Bible. There are some passages that are purely laws in the Bible, but the vast majority of the Bible is stories, it's history, it's poetry, but it's called law in its entirety. This means it's all authority to us, and it's not suggestions to us, it's authority, it's law to us. So we need to emphasize that the Bible has authority over our lives. It's something that is substantial and for us to feed on. If we believe it's genuinely got authority over us, then it has to be binding on our lives. In verse 2 of Psalm 119, it says, Blessed are those who keep his statutes and seek him with all their heart. Well, what does this mean? Well, in Psalm 119, verse 52 explains that long ago I learned from your statutes that you established them to last forever. In other words, the word of God, which is mentioned in the Bible, last forever. That is saying to us that they're permanent. They're permanent. Doesn't change over time or in different places. Doesn't change because the world's culture is changing. So we have to let the word of God sit in judgment over what parts of the culture that we see. The Lord's word is in judgment over all our culture, not just part of it. Jesus says in Matthew chapter 5, verses 17 and 18, Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have not come to abolish them, but to fulfill them. For truly I tell you, until heaven and earth disappear, not the smallest letter, nor the least stroke of a pen, will by any means disappear from the law until everything is accomplished. So we need to value the Bible's majesty and authority. It's kingly, and it's telling us about Almighty God. It's relevant today and is relevant in this age and in every generation. Secondly, it's about tapping into the power of the Bible. There's no give or take with the Bible. The Bible doesn't change, but maybe sometimes we have to wrestle with it to understand it. And we need to understand how it can be relevant to us today. The New Testament makes it clear to us that we are supposed to become spiritually mature and not remain as children. God wants us to grow up. Paul says in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 14, Therefore, we will no longer be infants tossed back and forth by the waves and blown here and there by every wind of teaching. So we need to know what we believe and be able to defend it. We're to grow up and speak the truth in love. So we need to ask ourselves and challenge ourselves if we are maturing and growing up. Feeding on the Word of God means that we're tapping into its power to nourish and satisfy and help us grow. Like every good diet, it will help us to grow. This means we can't leave our Bibles on the shelf. We need to use them. And there are countless stories of people who, just through reading the Word of God, had life-changing experiences and came to know the Lord. God's transformed so many people through the reading of His Word, through the power of His Word. And thirdly, we need to walk in its light. The Bible is a guidebook for our life. The Bible is a light to our paths. You know, we all encounter darkness every day, you know, both from in ourselves, but also in the world around us. So if we're going to go forward on our Christian path, we need something to light the way. And there's no verse that describes this better than Psalm 119, verses 105. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. So we need light in our homes, our families, in our jobs, in our relationships. We need light to deal with the unexpected things, the challenges, the weaknesses or the sicknesses. But we need God in so many ways. And for everything we may face, God's word provides that light. Scripture shines all around us and illuminates the steps in front of us. God promises that we will have light to see what's in front of us, but it shows us only what the next steps are. It shows us only what we need. Maybe it's not good that we see too far ahead, but we see enough that we can see where we're going in the next steps. The Christian church has a real secret to the meaning of life and satisfaction. So we need to communicate this. We need to share God's word and proclaim it to those around us. Just like to read again from a few verses from this psalm. So from 97, oh, how I love your law. It is my meditation all the day. Thank you, Lord. So let's remember, there's three things that we need to do with God's word. We need to recognize its majesty and authority. We need to use its power and we need to walk in its light. Thank you. Let's pray just to close our time. Father, we thank you, Lord, that you have given us, Lord, your word. Father, we thank you for the power that it contains, Lord, that you speak to us through your word. Father, we pray that you help us to meditate more on your word, to let us spend time in your word, Lord, that we can come to know you more through your word. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you.